Hello everyone, I am Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. This is the 10th tutorial of StatPro. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to stretch a member to a specific node or another beam. So let's talk about it. Let's make it view from positive Z axis. I want to fill this gap. To do this, I have to stretch this member, or you can say I have to stretch this beam. To get stretch member command, I have to go here. There is stretch member command, but it's blank now because I have to select the member or beam first. Let's select it. Now this icon is alive. You can activate that command from here, or you can go to geometry option. Then here there is command stretch selected members. I am clicking on it. As I selected this member, and this member was the first member we have drawn, that's why here the number of member is on. If you want to change to another member, then you can give here the beam number. Now let's come to these options. There are four ways to stretch this beam. You can use that one which one is suitable for your position of beams and nodes. Let's start with the fourth one. If you want to stretch or extend this beam to this beam, then you have to choose this option. Now you have to define this beam. If you know the number of this beam, then you can input that number here, or you can use the cursor to select that beam. I am selecting on this beam. Then the number changes. It is beam number 4. Then I am clicking on apply. Then the magic happens. This beam stretches to this beam. Let's undo. If you want to stretch this beam to this node, then you have to choose this option to an existing node, or you can choose this option also. First one and third one is similar. If you know the coordinate of that node, then you can use this option. You can input the coordinates here. Let's try this one. I don't know the number of this node and coordinate of this node, so I have to select this node by a cursor. That's why I'm going here and clicking on this box. Then I will pick this node now. Then here I can see the node number, so it is selected. Now I will click on apply. As I click apply, this beam has been stretched to this node. Let's undo and close. This time I will input the coordinate of this node. Now our cursor is beam cursor. I am making it node cursor. Then I am double clicking on this node. Then I am getting the coordinate of that node 240. Let's close it and change the cursor to beam cursor. Then select the member. Then come here for stretch member command. This time I want to input the coordinates here. Our x coordinate was 2, y coordinate was 4, and z coordinate was 0. Then I am clicking on apply. Similarly, that beam has been extended to this node. Let's undo again, and this time I want to use this second option. To use this, you have to know which one is the start node and which one is the end node of this beam. I hope you know how to check the start node and end node of a beam. As I said in the previous videos, to check this, let's close it. Then hold the cursor on this beam. As I hold the cursor on this beam, it is showing the start point, that is green, and the end point, it is blue. We all know that. Let's select this beam and go to stretch member command. And this time I am using this option. As I want to fill this gap, we will use this node, and it is the start node for this beam. So I am clicking on start node. Now I have to give how much distance I want to fill that, or I want to stretch that beam. This gap is 2 meters and it is coming left side, so I have to input negative value. I am inputting here -2. Then I am clicking on apply. Then my gap has been filled 2 meter. Let's close it and hold the cursor on this beam. Now this side has been starting side and this one is end side, so this node is start node. Now select that beam, go to this command, choose this option. Now I want to stretch this side 1 meter left, and it is the end point, so I have to click on this end node, and I will give here -1. Then I will click on apply. Then that beam has been stretched on left side 1 meter distance. This is how we stretch our beams or our members in Stradbroke. And this is all for today. If you have any questions or if you face any trouble, then please comment below, or you can use the email address that I have given to description. Till then, happy learning, keep practicing. See you in the next video.